with the kind help of the Creator upon us all, we always need to remember that our individual private mission in life, even though for sure is the closest one to our hearts, and we can understand it, and we feel ourselves first, we should always remember that we are a branch of a greater tree, and we are part of something that is much larger and more meaningful than our individual lives. And when you shake and you move a branch of a tree, by that you cause an effect to all the rest of the branches, to all the rest of the fruits, all the rest of the leaves of that tree. And sometimes people that are standing far away from you, or animals, or all kinds of creations, they will see the movement of that tree. And by that movement of that tree, their life will be changed as well. Their life will be affected as well. And that is a very important thing to know. Not only your life are being changed when you take a turn in life, when you come to a decision, to a conclusion. Many times, the ones that are surrounding you are being affected by that decision. And more than that, we can see that also souls that are, seems to be physically, that are located far away from you, they can also be affected by your decisions. And this is a physical explanation, when spiritually things are even much deeper than that physical explanation, because we are all wired spiritually from within. And like the Jacob letter, we are all standing one above his friend and under the other friend. And whenever we're climbing, we're pushing all those ones that are above us to a higher level than that level that they were standing on before. And we're also pulling all those ones that are standing under us to the next one, because we are all like a chain. And this is a very important lesson. Sometimes you feel heaviness. You feel that there is a huge effort on your shoulders, and it's very, very hard for you to take a decision, or to sit and learn, or to pull yourself to prayer, or to commit yourself to do tshuva, to apologize to someone. Sometimes it's so hard to say I love you, to say I apologize, I'm sorry that I hurt you. Sometimes the challenge of facing the truth and admitting it is so hard and so heavy. And when you look at yourself, you can ask yourself, why? Why is it so hard to say I love you? Why is it so hard to say I'm sorry? Why is it so hard to admit I was wrong? To say a good word, to stop criticizing your friend. The reason for that is that you are not alone. There are many, many souls, spirits, people that depends on you. And when you're going to complete your mission, and when you're going to do your job, and when you will find that power inside yourself to say I'm sorry, to say I love you, to admit the truth, to do tshuva, to take responsibility on your actions, you're not going to be the only one to be affected by that change. Not only the first circle of your loved ones will be those ones to enjoy your effort. Also, larger circles that are surrounding you spiritually. Also, people that are attached to you, and they are very, very far away from you, in a very long distance spiritually, but still they are tied to you in that chain. When you gonna rise to the next level and gonna be able to say the truth and to take responsibility on your actions and to express your honest heart and your deepest feelings, by that you're gonna pull them from the lowest places that they are lying down in deep sadness, in horrible depression, with a horrible and broken self-esteem, and you're gonna give them strength, and you're gonna pull pure water upon them, and you're gonna wash their darkness away from them, and you're gonna brighten their lives by taking your own responsibility while dealing and handling your own life challenges. And this is why that heaviness sometimes is holding us back. And this is why sometimes we feel that it's too heavy and it's too hard. And actually the thing that you are being asked to do is something very minor, very simple, very basic. But the fact that there are thousands on thousands of souls that depends on you spiritually, and your development will affect their life, is making this journey very, very complex. And this is why also when you make a small step in life and a tiny progress, you should always remind yourselves of that knowledge that you just earned, that you just heard from someone who knows what he's talking about, and that's me. My life experience brought me to some deep understandings, and many of those things are written in ancient books and in scripts that are holy and known and famous and accepted to the nation of Israel. And in that wonderful path of a person to seek and look for the real truth, he finds answers in very deep levels and in very meaningful ways. The way to know that your achievements and that your understandings are really connected to the truth is when you see that the light that is shining upon you is not hurting others, and it's shining and is fixing and is helping the ones who surrounds you. When you see that you are able to spread peace and to spread quiet and relaxation and wisdom and solid and stable and straight and right conclusions to the world, and you're helping and you're healing and you're supporting and you're stabilizing and assisting others, by that you can know and assure yourself that your path is accepted and blessed from heaven. But when you see that you hurt people, it's the time to do tshuva. If you see in your journey that you hurt people, that you find yourself that you disrespect people, that you're hurting feelings and emotions of loved ones, of people who are close to you, it's the time to take full responsibility on your actions and to try to fix and improve your ways in front of the King of all kings, that is reflecting and showing, sending signs and hints from every angle, from every figure, from every form of life, from every creation and creation on earth. He is sending his message to you to guide you how to walk in the path of truth, how to become your true potential, how to unlock your true potential and to achieve the goals that have been set for you in your path, how to express the godliness that is treasured inside of you and to make yourself a better person, to become that spiritual one, portion of heaven that you are from within, to be a person of God, a man of God, a woman of God, to be a holy person that is able to express only goodness, only kindness, only love, only honor, only respect, only good attributes, and to control yourself and to hold back all the anger and all the frustration and all the sadness and black bitterness that is surrounding our thoughts so many times. A person that is able to control his spirit and to control himself in time of fight, in time of argument, to control himself in time of sadness, in time of fear. That is a hero. That is a person that is a vessel to contain the bounty, to contain the blessing. May the Creator open our eyes and bless our hearts always to stand in front of the truth, thirsty for it, and glad and satisfied to know it, and to remember that the worst and most ugly truth of them all is much more beautiful and meaningful than the most fancy and gorgeous lie that someone can make up and pretend to have in this world. Group of liars cannot see the face of heaven, and a person of truth, the Creator, is blessing him and helping him in all he is doing in his life. So may we be honest, and may the Creator give us the opportunity to fix everything we spoiled and ruined, and that those days of tshuva will bring us to the coming up year with pure hands, with a pure heart, with pure intention, with pure thoughts, and that gates of prayers will be opened for us all to bring down the light of redemption, to reveal the light of the real Mashiach and not Mashiach of lies and sheker. And may the glory and beauty of the Almighty be revealed upon all His children who carry His light for the good. Amen. Amen. Ken yehi ratzon.
The world does not exist because olam milshon ne'elem. The world is just blocking the light of truth. The world called alma deshika, world of lies, is just a fake. We're just inside of an illusion. It's just a fake. We're just inside of an illusion.
We're just inside of an illusion.